I've been fighting it for 6 hard years. Dr. Amaral was developing a cure for the Cronon syndrome. She was the only one who could administer the treatments that kept my sickness at bay.
Paul?
And Jack had taken her away from me.
How the fuck did this happen, Morton? How is it possible they managed to take her?
Paul, this is your illness talking. I'm on your side. Easy. You're...
They took her. Without Sophia, there's no chance of a cure.
We did all we could. But there are forces within Monarch working against you, and I believe Burke was just the tip of the iceberg. It wasn't just Joyce that did this.
Sir? We've recovered Dr. Amaral's laptop. We have it set up over there if you want to take a look.
I'll be right there.
I want to go over Sophia's figures. If she's right, the fracture is escalating a lot faster than we anticipated.
You know the future. Dr. Amaral doesn't. Is the lifeboat even in a viable state for activation? She's trying to convince you the schedule's wrong. Why? To get you to rush this? To make a mistake? The people opposing you. She could be one of them.
She isn't.
Are you willing to bet the entire plan on that? I implore you, hold off on activation, Paul. Let me clean house before this gets completely out of hand.
I should have been here. Somebody made a false report. Sent me to the tunnels to divert my attention.
Like I said, how do you want to proceed?
Somebody was working against me. Somebody close. Martin Hatch. Sophia Amaral. I could only trust one of them.
I want him apprehended. Immediately.
Sir, I have some information about Martin Hatch.
Martin had been my closest advisor for years. I began to wonder if that had been a mistake.
Sophia's loyal. She's always been loyal.
I don't think we can trust her. The way she looked at the countermeasure like she's seen it before. She knows what it does.
Sophia's research had saved my life. Loyalty doesn't run any deeper. Evidence was mounting against Sophia. I couldn't simply ignore it, despite everything we had been through.
And she knew you'd never make it without those treatments. And she took them away.
If she'd turned against me with what she knew, the damage could be immeasurable. You're right. We need to stick to the original plan. Whether Sophia's date is good or not, we can't deviate from that. Clearly, we have been compromised. Put a team together. Find out who she's been working with.
Actually, I've already got something on that front. They just pulled this from the security feed.
My God, it's her.
Who?
Her, Martin. She's one of our employees. How the hell?
We got too big for you to screen everybody personally. We didn't have an ID on her. Until now. Beth Wilder. She's one of our operatives. We've already got a kill team after, but...
We won't be able to kill her. Not yet. How can she be working with Jack? How does she even know him?
I told you, Paul, we can't trust our own people. Who knows how deep this goes?
Find out. Beth Wilder. It was the first time I'd heard her name, but she had been there in the past. When it all started, she'd been here the whole time, working against me from the inside. And she wasn't the only one.
The treatments.
The hatch.
And what did Burke want with it?
Well, I don't know. I don't even know what the lifeboat protocol is.
It's a sanctuary designed to shelter a list of Monarch's essential personnel to weather the storm until they can develop a solution.
Essential personnel. So that means that I'd be on that list, right?
Not under Paul Serene's lead, you wouldn't. He's failed to see the value in his own people. Too consumed with grand ideals and delusions. You know what I find to be the most terrifying notion on this planet? The idea of God. Simply the idea. A being with that much power. The ability to take and give so freely. That kind of control. It should be feared, not worshipped. Yet people believe in it. Just as people believe in Paul Serene. See, what's so scary about God isn't his control, but rather, if he ever lost it, Paul Serene's become unhinged, Charlie. He's triggered a catastrophe. He has the chance to fix it, but he's choosing not to. He's choosing to let things end.
The end of time.
And this is where we come in. We risk too much leaving the keys to the kingdom in one man's hands. We need insurance. There's something called the CFR. It's a crucial key to our survival and must remain safe. But as long as Paul is the only one with access to it, it isn't. With access to the CFR, I would take over, get Monarch back on track, and once I do, Restructuring would be in order, Charlie. Restructuring that would see you as my right hand.
I'd be on the list.
Absolutely.
Then I need to go back to Monarch. And that sort of privilege escalation, it can only be done from the inside.
I put the island on lockdown, but the pump house on the west side has an old supply tunnel that runs beneath the bay. No one knows about it. You'll go unseen. Time is of the essence, Charlie. Better get to it. Commander Davis.
Yes, sir.
Head to the perimeter lab. We're moving forward.
The frequency of the stutters is still unpredictable, but they're persistent. Erratic, but persistent.
I need certainty. If I initiate the protocol, there's no going back.
Mr. Serene, something like this. There is no certainty. We've never dealt with it before.
How long?
We've been running Dr. Amaral's simulations. It's hard to say without her to confirm, but...
Just give me a time.
The Joyce Field could collapse within 8 hours. Mr. Serene, if you're going to proceed, now would be the time to decide.
Time's ending, just like you said. And the lifeboat protocol, it's a place. They built it to protect people from the fracture. And the only problem is there's a list, and anyone who's not on it is pretty much fucked. But if we make it back to the mainland, I can get us on the list. All of
this entire island is on lockdown. How are we gonna do that, Charlie?
There's a tunnel.
All right, if you are lying to me this time, I swear to God.
No, get off! Tired as shit. I don't know why you're doing this, but I don't have to put your name on shit, motherfucker.
What'd you do to him?
He's fine. I'm gonna tell you why you're gonna put me on that list. I got a pregnant wife at home, and she's the only thing that I am thinking about right now. So if you get in the way of me protecting her, I swear to fucking God, next time, you will not catch your breath. Lead the way.
Thank you.
Dr. Emerald.
Squirmed in my restraints. So, he said, here we are.
5 minutes out, Mr. Hatch.
What is that?
Not sure. Just playing when we came in.
Into the darkest dungeon, located in the soft depth of the...
Come to free you, my friend. This imprisonment, it's unsettling. It's time for you to rejoin the others, to return to the infinite.
Your wife?
3 months.
Congratulations.
You okay?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I'm good. We need to
get on the fucking ground!
Hey,
ground!
No, we're with Monarch!
What don't you understand?
No,
get on the ground!
Hey, no. Hey, I'm the one that called it in. I'm Hatch's guy.
Wincott?
Yeah.
Where's she?
She's Chronon scientist. She's important. We have to get her back to Monarch right away. Please.
Get the fuck out of here.
Now! Yeah.
Gibson, I got Burke.
Fiona! Fiona, you gotta listen. Hey!
Ah! Oh, shit, you killed him!
Fuck! Hey! I didn't know that they were gonna kill him. What was I supposed to do? Huh? You led me on and then you kidnapped me.
This isn't about you, Charlie!
Are you stealing this car?
Just get the fuck out of here.
No, you're gonna need me.
I got what I needed out of you.
Yeah, I'm getting used to it.
Why don't you open your eyes? The world is about to end. I'm trying to do something.
Yeah, you're a real hero.
Fuck you.
A nurse, huh? I'll see you there.
Burke. You fuck.
You know, I'm really gonna enjoy killing your wife.
Commander Davis?
Davis and his team. They're all good men. Monarch's finest.
Paul. Paul, what about my treatments?
I'm afraid so.
You know what this means.
You don't know for sure.
I'm a dead man! Jack. He wants me to become you. He wants me to suffer. Until the end.
Joyce and Wilder. But what was troubling me is who got them into Kim's lab. She paid a visit while she was thought to be missing. She knew where your treatments were kept. She knew the complexities of your illness. And she knew you'd never make it without those treatments.
She created them.
And then she took them away.
I need her found now.
And what would you like done with her?
I'll decide that when she's brought to me. Hey, pal. I'm glad you could make it. I was just telling your girl here how concerned about you we've been.
Emily, we need to go.
Go? What's the rush?
Emily, let's go.
Yeah.
Emily, give me the keys. Give me the keys,
get
Emily.
Away from me,
Emily, listen.
No.
Listen, please. Please, please. This is not who I am. This is not. I'm telling you, I never felt good doing this. I never felt good doing this. But it's the only thing I knew how to do. And when I got back, I couldn't find anything. I couldn't find anything to do. And Monarch, they found that useful, and they put me to work. And I swear to God, I couldn't stand being alone. So every Tuesdays and Wednesdays, I would walk down the street because it was the only two nights at the bartender. She wasn't at school. And I told myself every night to ask you out. It took me a fucking year. Emily, if Monarch, if they gave me... structure, you gave me purpose. I did this to protect you. I did this to protect us, our family. I did this to protect our family. And Emily, you have to listen to me. Something terrible is coming, and I will explain to you on the way, but we have to move. We have to move right now. If you will just let me, if you will just let me protect you one last time.
It's Pierce. I'm at the perimeter lab.
Sir, I have some information about Martin Hatch.
I want him apprehended. Immediately.
You took the one thing Mr. Serene needed to survive, Dr. Amaral. That made you priority one.
Yeah, they made that clear. Monarch lined every escape route with barricades, roadblocks. I had to get to the mainland, but I couldn't do it by car. Needed a new plan.
All right, let's go.
Beth, I think I'm gonna need a ride. The streets are too hot.
All right, where do you want me?
I'll let you know as soon as I find some higher ground and get a good look at the situation on the bridge. I think it might be a no-go. Gotta get to higher ground. Well, maybe.
Or I can pick you up. Let me know. I'm pretty exposed out here, so try to make it fast.
I'll be a lot better when you get me on that boat. Come on. product's right up my ass. I'm not exactly making friends out here. How's Dr. Amaral?
Still kicking and screaming. How long do you need to get here?
That depends. Let me check. Better get inside before the chopper spots me. Gas sign out front. Can't miss it.
It's nice and bright for Monarch to see.
There's not a lot of options. Switching to Monarch frequencies. Be in touch soon.
And I'll be there in a few minutes. Don't stand me up.
Okay.
For those of you just tuning in, the manhunt continues as authorities search for Jack Joyce, the suspect in last night's university terrorist.
We're helping the police looking for a terrorist. Have you seen anything out of the ordinary? That's the guy who blew up the light. James Joyce? Right. Yeah. You see anything out of the ordinary? Well, I mean, there's a sports car parked on the street back there. It's kind of wrecked. A little unusual. Please, show me where. Right now.
Damn it. Better hurry.
This criminal, a terrorist known as Jack Joyce. Thanks for your continued patience. Please talk to one of our security personnel if you have anything to report.
Joyce!
My plan to meet Beth went out the window as soon as the stutter hit.
Her boat couldn't get to you?
No. But it gave me an opportunity to climb up on the bridge and cross it. Slip right past Monarch, more or less undetected. I should get up on that bridge and make my way across it before this stutter ends. The scene on the bridge was unreal. They weren't cops. They had no authority to do this. But the Monarch PR machine had done its job. Here they were, the heroes protecting everybody.
And you were the terrorist.
Yeah. Man, I'm not the one you should be scared of, guy.
Just be patient, folks. We're just making sure.
Thank you. Okay, good. It's cool. Just gotta make it across this damn bridge and I'll be clear. This is so bad.
I knew I'd be dead if the stutter collapsed while I was in the frozen crack.